Good afternoon, all of you. This is Dr. Desai from Keli Technological University, Hubli, Karnataka. Today I am here to present one of our work titled Molecular Skit. It's a role play as a pedagogical tool for teaching the molecular biology at undergraduate level. So myself and my colleagues, Dr. Gopal Krishna Joshi, Professor Ella Patil, and Guraj Tenari also contributed to the work being carried out. So to start with, as the saying of William Shakespeare goes, all the world is a stage and all the women and men are merely players. So a role play or a skit is an active method of learning process wherein the students enact the role of some assumed character and perform on the stage. Essentially, it is bringing alive a concept that is theoretical in nature onto the stage, and thereby they involve themselves in an active method of learning the concepts. So the Oxford Dictionary states that the role play is the acting out of a particular role, and it had its beginning since many years, and it's already been practiced for teaching subjects like history, sociology, political science, medicine, mathematics, science, and of late engineering also. So here in this case, we have made an attempt to drive home the concepts of molecular biology, that is the biology at the molecular level, by using this method of role play on the stage. So role play helps the students to understand the minute aspects of the subjects that is involved, and it keeps the students involved and interested. And it's also known to integrate the knowledge and action, and thereby exploring the alternatives and explore the creative approaches for the learning concept. So as such, in general, to discuss about the advantages of the role play as a pedagogical tool, it is widely regarded as an active learning method wherein the students involve themselves in active participation in understanding the subject.
Hello, sir.
It is known to enhance the... Yes, sir?
Sir, put it in full screen.
Yeah. Fine.
Yes,
sir. Okay. So, role play is known to enhance the cognitive or the learning skills of the students. It is known to increase or improve the temporal and spatial learning. Temporal here, I need to tell the learning abilities that are related to the time, and the spatial learning related to the three-dimensional aspects of understanding the subjects, making them to imagine the things. So role play plays a critical role in the temporal and spatial learning in making the students understand the subjects of the timing of the events and helping them to imagine in a three-dimensional space. And since they involve themselves in the playing of a drama, and before that drafting of the technical sketch of the play that they are going to perform, it is known to enhance their communication skills, both written as well as oral. And in the entire concept of the role play, wherein they narrate the concept, story building methodology is involved, wherein their creative skills are being brought to the forefront, and they themselves will be trying to build a story to drive home the concepts that are inherent in the topic. And at the end, another advantage of a role play is, since the role play is played members of 4 to 6 in a team, it brings them a sense of teamwork and articulation amongst themselves, so that they can bring the whole show in a nutshell. And eventually, one among them will be emerging as a leader who will be coordinating all the activities in the role play, and it's known to enhance the leadership skills among the students. So all these are known to be the advantages of having the role play as a pedagogical tool. And to brief you about the activity of role play that we have undertaken initially the course selected is molecular biology. It is an undergraduate course wherein the biology is being studied at the molecular level as part of a biotechnology program. And molecular biology is the study of biological concepts like DNA to study at the molecular level. The course was for 3 credits, and the target group of students were undergraduate students of engineering of the 4th semester biotechnology belonging to KLE Technological University here at Hubli, Karnataka. And the details of the role play activity are the participating students on the stage. At the same time, the student audiences who are on the other side of the platform, and myself, the course supervisor or instructor. And as far as the group dynamics is concerned, the students were at liberty to form their own team of 4 members each. And the different topics that were chosen for the role play were based upon the discussion of students and the course instructor, taking into consideration the feasibility of the enacting and the significance of the concept as a whole that centers around the course of molecular biology. And thirdly, the topics were chosen such that the topics spanned most of the chapters of the course content. So with this background, after having chosen the course content and the topics, after discussing with the students, we went on for the role play, which essentially consisted of 2 phases. The first phase sketch, and the second phase is the enacting part of the role play. In character sketch, it involved mainly the technical write-up of the topic by each of the team that has got. Then they were to build a story around the concept to drive home the concept in a layman's line. Also, the character assumed different roles in the story building, and with the help of that story, the technical content was elucidated. So this comprised of the character sketch. The next was to bring that character sketch, which was a technical draft, onto the stage by acting out. And this involved the dialogue delivery in accordance with their assigned roles. The play, usually all the topics in each of the team, they started with an introduction of the topic. Gradually, it encompassed the technical concept of the topic. Accordingly, based upon each of the topic, the costumes, the supporting properties, and the use of vernacular languages wherever applicable and felt appropriate, along with the proverbs were made use of for better effective communication of the concepts in the role. Nainu, are you able to hear me? Am I audible? Hello? The topics chosen accordingly were, there are 11 groups, each comprising or having taken one topic. Some of the topics that were chosen were Meselson and Stahl experiment, then DNA replication, then tumor suppressor genes, transcription and its inhibition, then DNA mutations, and apoptosis, lac operon concept, Griffith's experiment, Avery Matillard experiment, trip operon, DNA repair mechanism. These are some of the key topics that were chosen for the activity of the role play. So this is a case study of a character casting of one of the topic, that is DNA mutations, amongst those 11 discussed earlier. A topic, say for example, a topic called DNA mutation. It started as a first stage. A group of members of 4 comprising would be moving in an unusual way on the stage, and one among those he showcased as an alien character. He will be moving in an unusual way. One of the person interrogates him, and he narrates he was an ordinary man, but he has become an alien because of a phenomenon called as mutation, and hence he is moving in an unusual way. Next, the story unveils as he narrates about what is mutation and why the mutation occurred to him. And as a result of what happened to him is that he was moving in an unusual way, and there are some changes that have brought to him. And at this juncture, the members of the team would be wearing placards that were written as A, T, G, and C that were written on both sides. A refers to adenine, T refers to thymine, G refers to guanine, and C refers to cytosine. So when A is turned on the other side, it showed T, that means there is a mutation occurring. And different types of mutations occur, which are called as the transition, transversion, base pair, frame shift mutation, and insertion and deletion. They were demonstrated on the stage with the help of these placards, wherein the placards would be written on both the sides, and when they were overturned, A would be shown as T and T would be shown as C, thereby showing that a mutation had occurred. Next, this was followed by an oral briefing of the events that goes in tandem, and finally the play concluded with the all members underscoring the significance of mutations as raw materials in the evolutionary process of humans or any organisms that take place. The role play in the context of the outcome-based education mainly aimed at attaining the following program outcomes or graduate attributes. First, we were aiming to have a program outcome number one, that is engineering, wherein the application of the knowledge of mathematics, science, engineering fundamentals were being demonstrated. Then we have program outcome 9, which included individual and teamwork that demonstrated an ability to form a team and define a role for each member. And we aimed at attaining program outcome number 10, where it included the communications in the form of oral communication and written communications. And a response survey for the entire role play activity was undertaken at the end of the event. The typical questions that were included were, was role play a new experience of learning or had practiced earlier? As a participant in a role play, the understanding of the concept, whether it increased significantly, or whether there was only an increase, or whether the understanding was the same or it reduced. Another question in the survey was, how did script drafting and enacting on the stage help the students in enhancing the learning curve? They were asked whether what were the difficulties that were encountered while writing script and enacting on the stage. And the support and guidance of the supervisor was asked whether it was good, very good, average or poor. And there was a provision for any suggestions for making the role play concept more effective in terms of the marks allotted, time for enacting on the stage, interactions of the course instructor and student groups, the choice of topics, the group formation and the questions. There were rubrics that were set for assessing the performance of the students on the stage and during the technical content or drafting of the concept. Accordingly, for the technical content, it was considered as excellent or exemplary if the biological concept of the topic covered was sufficient enough. There was a good story reading trait and there were use of proverbs or contextual references. Similarly, if they were lacking, they were treated as unsatisfactory, and if they were average, they were treated as satisfactory. As far as the rubrics for assessment in terms of their enacting on the stage was concerned, there were two parameters. One is the dialogue delivery, which included the clarity and the fluency of the speech and the team coherence. And there was the stage usage in terms of the properties and the costumes they wore. And if they were optimum, accordingly, they were classified as excellent or exemplary, satisfactory and unsatisfactory. So I'd like to play a video clipping of the role play of the different clippings of the various activities or the topics that we performed. The response summary included the following points, wherein the students were of opinion that role play enhanced the level of understanding of the concepts better, and the role play or the skit playing was a new method of learning experience for all the students. They had an exercise of story building and creative thinking, and further their use of costumes and properties could be more effectively used. And some opined that it helped them in overcoming stage fear, and they felt that a new rehearsal before the grand performance was expressed. So to conclude, the role play was instrumental in enhancing the learning of the course concepts and honing the communication skills of the students. It provided the students with an opportunity to build a story out of a theoretical concept which was hitherto not practiced. Students had an opportunity to get engaged in active learning. The activity instilled creative thinking and understand team dynamics, and it was overall a new experience of teaching learning process, and there are plans to implement the role play for a second cycle with more effectiveness which are being practiced. So the selected references are one from Blackner and another is from Christina and Mary Hepner. Before I conclude, I'd like to thank the organizers for arranging this webinar and all the audiences. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yeah.
We're giving the audience 1 or 2 minutes. We'll give the audience 1 or 2 minutes, sir, in case they are typing their question.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. There seem to be no questions right now.
Yes.
But if you can display your email ID, they might be interested.
Yes. Yes. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can you see? I have typed.
No, sir. Is it on the slide?
No, it's the text box. Text box below chat and one more box.
Okay.
desaisp@bvb.ed.
Okay, sir.
Can you see it, sir, or should I retype it?
Just tell me, sir, again, I'm going to type it. DESAISV.
DESAISV.
At. Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
I repeat.
Yes, sir.
DESAISV.
Yes, sir.
@bvb.edu.
Okay, sir.
desaisp@bvb.edu.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much for the webinar. And if any email come in, I will forward. Fine. Sir.
Fine. If there are any queries, sir, please let them email to me. I will be able to respond to those.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Were you able to hear the video clipping, sir?
Yeah, mostly, sir.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you.
Fine, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.